Lily has now been stormed by an overwhelming hunch where she is sleeping. The seams in her head continue growing until they abruptly cause her to wake up. She is dripping in sweat, completely empty-minded. She has already been having nightmares from about a month now. Every night, as soon as she falls asleep, the images of her own death haunt her. She envisions herself being poisoned by a lovely cup of tea. Suddenly, the telephone rings and Lily picks it up.
My parents said I could dance before I could walk. From a really young age, I discovered my passion and talent for ballet. So when I had the opportunity to enter the Royal Ballet, I moved to London to pursue my dream. In the ballet, I met two of my best friends. Ruby, who taught me how to survive among fake and competitive co-workers, and Scarlett, whose caring words gave me enough courage to get the leading role in the upcoming play, The Sleeping Beauty. However, it was on days like this that I felt like I was living in a horror movie.
Are you alright? It seems like you have seen a ghost.
I'm okay, it's just that I haven't had enough sleep for quite a while now, and I keep having the same nightmare every night.
The leading role is a physical and psychological challenge. Maybe it's too much pressure for you.
Look, Ruby and I are going to have a cup of coffee after class. Do you want to come?
I can't, I have no practice.
You have to come. We haven't seen you since the announcement of the roles. You need to relax.
Okay, I'll go.
Girls, I'm sorry for being this late. I paid for your services in compensation. First, I need to go to the room.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. I was just searching for you. I know you're in trouble, but I need you to keep it calm.
Keep it calm? How on earth? But who are you?
Listen to me, darling. I know you're in danger, and I know you're well aware of it. I need you to be wary. Here's my contact information. Whenever you think you need help, just give me a call and I'll cover you back. And please, do not trust or tell anyone.
Are you okay? You seem pale.
Yeah, has something happened to you in there?
No, it might be just long, sure.
What was I thinking? I shouldn't have accepted that coffee. I missed my practice, now I can't sleep, and even worse, that strange man is trying to make me crazy. Even more, if that's possible.
I hope it's not that
night. Hi, Lily. I hope I didn't catch you sleeping.
No, falling asleep has been a challenge for a month now.
Yes, we have noticed your fatigue. You know, Ruby was right earlier. Playing the Sleeping Beauty requires great strength. But I'm absolutely certain that you will succeed. Right now, you just need to take some rest and fight your imposter syndrome.
I understand, but it is not only the ballet that worries me. I've had a constant feeling of betrayal since the announcement of the roles. I think I'm going to die, and it is going to be soon.
What are you saying? You seriously need to sleep. You are getting a bit paranoid. I will give you some sleeping pills tomorrow, okay? Yeah? And don't worry, I will search for your Judas.
Okay, I'll see you tomorrow.
Good night.
She has been feeling betrayed since the announcement, and she knows how she's going to die. What does that mean?
I deserve it more than her. I definitely do. I've been working hard all of my life. I was even before Lily in the Royal Ballet. This is my home. That role should have been mine. This is my whole world. The instructors are mistaken for taking this decision, but it does not matter because that will not happen. Lily is going to end up rejecting the role and I will take it. I'm a better dancer anyway. It will only benefit the Royal Ballet's image. The best dancer should be the one taking the Sleeping Beauty's lead role and I will do everything possible to get it.
I want something that will keep anyone awake.
Then these pills will do.
Okay, I will take them. Are they safe?
I mean, there's a reason these pills are not sold in regular pharmacies. If you're taking medicine from me, I would advise you to be careful with them.
Okay, thank you. I will take them. Wait, what is this?
This. This is cyanide. It could kill anyone.
Okay,
I'm going
to take this.
I hope you took that nonsense of dying out of your head.
I know, but things have been weird lately.
Yeah, but you should be focused on resting.
You shouldn't be feeling this way, Lily. You have to make sure that you are physically and mentally prepared for this role. You are representing the Royal Ballet.
And I'm trying my best.
Of course you're trying your best. You always do.
Your health comes first. You should know that. If you're feeling this tired and pressured, maybe you shouldn't take this role.
I have worked so hard that I just can't give it up now.
I think that there is no one more suitable for this role than you, Lily.
I have some beautiful aspirins. There's coffee for us and lime tea for you. It will help you relax.
Yeah, you should have some.
Thank you. Thank you.
How considerate of you to call this early in the morning. Who's this? What do you want?
Listen, I beg you to listen to me. There's no time for trifles. Someone's behind you and you have to protect yourself. This is not a joke. I know you have been feeling it. I'll give you a proper explanation pronto. Bye.
Lily is shocked and confused now. Everything was starting to feel strange to her.
I recognize you. You just called me this morning.
Indeed, it's Mr. Noir. He's Noir, your new secret detective. And I am here to protect you from your possible future mother.
What? Is someone trying to kill me?
You tell me. Didn't you notice that everything seems strange lately?
I've been having some nightmares lately. In the last one, I lay abed. I don't really know what that means.
As I suspected, you are suffering from an anxiety disorder because of the feelings you are experiencing. But don't worry, Lily. I am here to take care of you. You just need to be cautious.
Oh, this is unbelievable. Thank you for informing me, Hayden. I'll be aware.
We are moving in the right direction. Yes. This is cyanide. It could kill anyone.
Okay, I'm going to take this.
So this is what Ruby is capable of if a role is at stake. I knew that Anderson's daughter was a spoiled girl since she was born, but I didn't expect her to go this far to get something she wanted. She's truly evil. Her wealthy parents have always been telling her that she is deserving of everything and that she should do anything to get it. Nevertheless, I don't think that Lily deserves this malignant fate.
God damn it, it's too fucking late!